With this video, we will be doing Taylor Swift, and the name of the song is All Too Well. And if you want to help this channel and the content that we're making, please help support our merchandise. The link is in the description. And if you didn't hit the like button, make sure to hit the like button. Try and get the channel to grow. And the only way we're going to do this, if you like, share, and comment on the content. So without further ado, let's get into Taylor Swift, All Too Well. Let's go. Chi-Chi, get the yayo.
Get the yayo. All Too Well, 10-minute version, Taylor's version from the vault.
From the vault. She be giving us some bangers from the vault.
Yeah.
We did like two already from the vault.
Yeah, I was like, how is this in the vault?
Yeah, it should be in the vault.
She got hella content.
Definitely.
I walk to the door with you. The air was cold, but something about it felt like home somehow. And I left my scarf there at your sister's house, and you still got it in your drawer even now.
She said, you still got my scarf I left at your sister's house. You even got it even still now. And if that's true, I mean, that film made an impact on you. Because if she didn't, you just went through the stuff away and moved on with life. So if you still got it somehow, some way, she still got to hold on to you. She living in your head rent-free.
Yeah, it's a deep connection there. And it's definitely rent-free in your head.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's crazy to hear her saying that herself. Like, somehow.
Yo, her writing game is amazing.
Yeah.
And my wide-eyed gaze, we're singing in the car, getting lost upstate.
Okay.
Autumn leaves falling down like pieces into place, and I can picture it after all these days. And I know it's long gone, and that magic's not here no more, and I might be over.
She said, I love not here no more. I might be fine, but I'm not okay. So basically, the way things are is not the way I want them to be. I'm dealing with them because that's the situation I'm in. Or where they would say, playing the cards, I'm dope. But these are not really the cards I want. These are only cards I got in my hand.
It sounds like a situation that has went from enjoyable to tolerable.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? She's just trying to get through.
It seemed like
it's not there no more.
It seemed like every song with Taylor that we do so far, it seemed like she break down almost every emotion that's inside of a relationship. The good, the bad, the ugly, pretty much everything you're going to go through in a relationship, she puts it in songs.
With such a level of clarity.
Yes, and she painted a picture so clear. Even when she was talking about driving in the car, the leaves falling, you could visually picture all that in your head.
Yeah.
That magic's not here no more, and I might be okay, but I'm not.
That reminded me, we was coming from the gym one day, and I had looked over, it was a lady over there, I had looked over, and time I looked back, I almost cried, like, oh, snap. So time I heard that situation came right back to my head.
On the counter, your cheeks were turning red, you used to be a little kid with glasses in a twin-sized bed, and your mother's telling stories about you on the t-ball team. You told me about your past, thinking you
she breaks down relationships so well, because when you get with a new person, you tell them about your past, you tell them how you grew up, you're also telling them about past relationships you've been in, certain situations using college, high school. So you tell them a lot about your past because you think they're your future. So you think, oh, she's dope.
Yeah, it's open book.
Yeah.
About your past, thinking if you choose me, and you were tossing me the car keys, but the
interestingly built. Like, it definitely is pop, but like it has like a, it feels almost like a country song.
Yeah, this was a nice blend she did with this. It got a nice groove. It's definitely inside of a nice pocket. And her songwriting ability on this is just crazy. Just making you feel like you're a part of this relationship I feel that like, she's singing about.
Like, she literally took a book from beginning to end, and she's just like, you know what I mean, filling us in.
Yeah. You kept me like a secret, but I kept you like an oath. It was a big difference. And the way she breaking this whole song down, when I'm interpreting that, the guy wasn't giving her the love that she was giving him. She said he didn't even say it was love until it was dead. It was over with. Right. Then you said we was in love. Why didn't you say we was in love when we was together, when I was reaching out for you? And it's crazy.
It's real. And you can tell that it's one of those songs that just sounds like it's so true.
Yeah,
you can feel it.
Yeah, swear to remember it all too well. Like, everything I just bought was a banger. Say, yo, you was being cruel in the name of being honest, because that's what God said. I'm just being honest.
Damn.
But she said, nah, you being cruel. I like how she put that.
And you know what? It's one of the things that's like, you know, even in honesty, you have to have a level of sensitivity about how you deliver your message.
Definitely. It's not what you say, it's how you say it.
Yeah. Cruel in the name of being.
She said, if you said it was close in the age, we would have been fine. And that made me want it to die, because she can't do nothing about the age gap. There's nothing she can do about the age gap. It's always going to be that many years apart until one of them is no longer here. So I felt that bar.
That was real. Me, who was she? A never needy, ever lovely jewel whose shine reflects on you.
If somebody asked me what happened, I'm telling them it was you. You what happened, yo?
Yeah, it was nothing else wrong with me. You was nothing wrong with me until I started talking to you.
Yo, that was crazy. You who charmed my dad with self-effacing jokes, sipping coffee like you're on a late night show. But then he watched me watch the front door all night, willing you to come, and he said it's supposed to be fun. Felt that. She said she's staring, looking at the door, and I'll wait for him to come back. And her dad is like, supposed to be fun being 21. You're not supposed to be sitting here looking at the door. You're supposed to be out having fun, enjoying your life. And that hit too.
Yeah, he just wanted to live her best life. Yeah. It sounds like she's going to do some things. And at this point, you're like, nah, get up, go out and do something.
Yeah, she said, you charm my dad. But even my dad saying, yo, it's not supposed to be like this.
Yeah, you're going through too much.
Yeah. From the revolt.
Time won't fly, it's like I'm paralyzed by it. I'd like to be my old self again, but I'm still trying to find it after pledge.
It's like, you know, when you're in a type of relationship, like she's talking about, you lose yourself. You feel what I'm saying? It do take you a while to find it. You just gotta look in the mirror and keep reminding yourself of who you was before this person entered your life and try to get back to that person. But it does take time. It's not an overnight success.
Yeah, like the best thing I've ever learned is, like, don't lose yourself in the first place. Like, yeah. Regardless. Yeah. Like, because it's going to be a rough ride back. It's real life.
Facts.
Sure days and nights when you made me your own. Now you mail back my things and I walk home alone. But you keep my own scarf from that very first week. Because it reminds you of innocence and it smells like me. You can't get rid of it.
And that was dope because the whole song she keep talking about, I remember it. I remember the whole situation. It's like a piece of paper crumbled up on the floor. But she said the only reason you keep my scarf is because you remember as well.
Yeah, and that's a tough part in itself. Yeah. Like, you know, the scents bring other thoughts.
Definitely bring back memories. Yeah.
You know what I mean? So she's hitting everything right on the dot.
Yeah. Because when you smell somebody's smell, even if you walk in a room and they're not in that room, and you smell that smell, you all might think of that person. She said what you had was rare.
Mm-hmm.
Now you don't even got it no more. It's just memories. We just talking about memories of something that could have been forever.
Yeah, it's a bad decision.
Okay. That guy was, but he pissed her off, I tell you that much.
That was real.
Facts. She remember everything, every second of that relationship. She said, I remember the snow, how Glisser. Like, it was crazy. It's Trey TV. Let's get it.
This is Lamar Wilson here representing Ghetto Action News Network _ all lower cases.
No spaces.
And you can catch us on Facebook. And when you do, make sure you hit the like button. All right, I'm going to get right into this. We got All Too Well, the 10-minute version, Taylor's version from The Vault. I'm having fun with her catalog.
Me too.
Everything's a new listen.
Yeah.
And this was pretty cool. It just felt like I was... It almost felt like if I was in a bad relationship and you had that last intimate moment, and then on your way out the house, she was like, hey, make sure you listen to this before I don't see you again ever.
Yeah.
And then that's how I felt about this song. Like, damn.
So
it was real. And it was a good listen. And it was a lengthy listen. I don't know. It's good music. What do you think about this? If I had to rate this, I'd give this a 9. I thought it was that good. And it was interesting because it was even though it was a lengthy piece, it almost didn't feel like I was listening to one song. It felt like it had moments where it was like transitioning and it was just kind of pieced together. But I thought it was dope. What you think?
That was a great song. I liked the way she wrote it. It almost made me feel like I was reading out of her diary about a relationship that she had, how she broke everything down so much. It's like her songs are just dope. She gave you so many vibes in this pocket right here. I definitely like this pocket. This type of song, if I was going through a breakup and I was feeling bad about this breakup, this type of song you would throw on and it'll make you feel better. And she got a couple songs that's like that. And I just like her catalog, and I can't wait to do more from my catalog. But if I had to rate this on a scale of 1 to 10, I gave it a lot higher than you. I gave it a 10 because I could just sit here and relate to it and vibe out. I think it's a dope song, something you just listen to around a fire or something and just chill and vibe out. It's a dope song, and I can't wait to do more from Taylor Swift. But until then, it's your boy Trey TV, and I'm out.